Hello everyone, I'm going to put the last final finishing touches to this little ATC card. See, it's rather small, this thing, just to compare. Let me see, this is how big it is roughly. You can see it compared to my nails, I mean. So I'm using Schmincke, if I pronounce it correct, watercolors, whole bunch of them. And in this case, let me see, Winsor & Newton, a very fine brush. So let's make those last few adjustments to it. Hair is always tricky to do. Takes quite a while to figure it out, and I wouldn't say that I've completely figured it out yet. But I've got a lot further than what I understood from it whenever you look back a few years. I'm currently using, I'm not too sure which color it is actually. I do have my reference little pieces of paper somewhere still. But it is the darkest, let me think. That's black, yeah, it's the darkest brown I have in my set. So if you have the big set, that's the one I'm going for right now. I haven't used any black in this little painting whatsoever. All the very dark colors you see are in this case the very dark brown, not black. It retains a, well, it's my opinion anyway. I believe that it retains more of the life, the vibrancy of the painting, if you never used black. Just as the white in the painting in this case is the white of the paper. I'm not really against using another medium for the white, because I've done that as well in the past. And I tend to mix media quite often, and in this case is this little ATC is more to, well, for myself anyway, to practice my watercolor only skills. The only other medium used is a graphite pencil from, in this case, let's see, Derwent. So I use this one for my sketch, and then one sketched out, and then I start painting, and that's it. So two mediums in this case. You can see I had already prepared a few layers here. So watercolor is all about layering. There were a decent amount of layers in here already, which takes ages. So So soon I will be more making more of these, but not the little cards. Soon I will move on to bigger watercolors in this style. In my never ever ending attempt to combine realism and fantasy together. It's like a quest. You have to be rather patient for this as well because you don't see a lot change. But it does pay off to take the time to brush all these hairs in. So we'll give it that realistic look. I think this one will eventually end up in my shop. I will probably sell it. Because I think there would be a few people that would be interested in that, so why not? It's an interesting little thing to collect. Paint was not as pigmented as I wanted. Well, the paint is pigmented, but whatever I had in my brush was not. So I had a rather watered down version of my palette. Put in a little bit more of the pigment, and there you go. Magic. To keep moving back and forward, building it up. Especially with this very thin brush, you have to dip it in water non-stop. Or in your paint with which is already diluted with water. Because else you won't get far with it. The brush itself doesn't hold a lot of water, so you run out of it very quickly. So in this case, to create this effect, I have used, let me think, two colors only. So the brown I'm using now, and then there's another lighter brown I will show you. Let's see, not that one, not that one, not that one. This one. So that brown and then the one next to it. So the two edges. Oh, let me think. No, it was that one. Sorry. That one and that one. So those two I've been using. So first I started with a light wash of the lighter brown. And then I did the same as what I'm doing now, but with a slightly thicker brush. It's only at the end with the darker color I'm taking the thin brush to give it some detail. I'm not just building up the layers, but also building up the contrast at the same time. I need to go darker and darker every time. So in my eyes, of course, the eyes I made and the eyelashes, they are so dark that it's almost black. But you need to make sure that the other pieces of your painting, which are, for example, the hair, that they have, at the darkest places, that they have something similar to black as well. Or at least something that is just as dark. It can be dark blue as well, it doesn't necessarily have to be brown. It needs to have that same level of darkness about it to make the whole painting work. Because you will find that it's not in balance if you have one part of the painting where you have very dark pieces and then the rest is just pastel colors without any contrast whatsoever. And we keep on building up like that, so I think you understood the principle behind it by now, of course. So I'm going to do the rest of the hair. This is almost finished, but I need to do the rest as well. Gives it a bit of a pencil-ish type of look, as you can see. And the paper I've been using was from, let me see. If I pronounce it correct, it should be Daler and Rowney. That's the paper I've been using, the Aquafine version. I'm quite happy with it so far. I've been using Arches as well, and it is similar enough to Arches. It seems to have a little bit of a film on it whenever you try to paint on it. Trying to figure out whether that comes from my eraser or whether it's just some sort of a film that's on the paper itself which does that. But I'll figure it out along the way. This paper, I haven't been using it long, but it does seem to do what I want, so I'm quite happy with it. That's me for today. Enjoy your day.